Welcome to the Math Review. This lesson is on dividing whole numbers by fractions. So let's say we have the following problem. So here we have a whole number, and we're dividing that whole number by the fraction 4/5. And it's important to make sure that we're comfortable with the terminology when we're talking about division. This 3 here is our dividend. This is the value that's getting split up. And this value here is the divisor. This is telling us how we're splitting up the dividend. And when we find our answer, that's going to be called the quotient. Now that we're familiar with the terminology, let's get straight to how we're going to do this. We're going to use a method called KCF. And KCF stands for keep, change, flip. But before we can use KCF, I'm going to rewrite the problem over here so that everything is a fraction. So whenever you're dividing and they're one of these values, the dividend or the divisor is a fraction, make sure you understand that everything needs to be a fraction. And to take this whole number and turn it into a fraction, we're just going to put it over 1. So again, what we're going to have to do is use keep, change, flip. Our first fraction here, we're going to keep. So let's put a K for keep, and that just means this 3 over 1, we're going to keep as 3 over 1. The sign, the division symbol, we're going to change, and we're going to change this division into multiplication. And the second fraction, the divisor, we're going to take it and flip it. So that 4 over 5 is now going to become 5 over 4. And just so you know, when you flip a fraction, the flipped form of the fraction is called the reciprocal. So now that we've kept our dividend, we kept it as 3 over 1, we changed our division into multiplication, and we flipped or found the reciprocal of our divisor, 4 over 5, that flipped to become 5 over 4. Now we just have to solve this. And it's not too bad because all we have to do is take the numerators and multiply them, and then take the denominators and multiply them. Here we're going to have 3 times 5, which equals 15. And then I'll have 1 times 4, which equals 4. So our answer here is 15 over 4, but that's improper. So what we're going to have to do is ask ourselves how many times 4 can go into 15. Or we can actually just divide it, and it'll look like this. So we're going to divide the numerator 15, so it goes inside the house, by the divisor 4, and that's going to go outside the house. 4 goes into 15 3 whole times. So now we've got 4 times 3, which is 12. And when I subtract that, I get 3. So I've got 4 going into 15 3 whole times. The remainder is 3. So that's going to be my mixed numbers numerator, and the denominator or the divisor is going to stay the same, and that's going to be 4th. So our final answer is 3 divided by 4 over 5 equals 3 and 3/4. So here's another example. Let's say we have 8 divided by 2/3, and we still want to find the quotient. So now that we have 8 divided by 2 over 3, we know that we have to use KCF. But like the last problem, we need to make sure that everything is a fraction, including the dividend. And how do we turn this dividend of 8 into a fraction? Well, we'll make it 8 over 1. So let's do that. So here we'll have 8 over 1 divided by 2 over 3. And we don't know what it equals yet, so let's get to work. So we're going to keep this 8 over 1. So I'll put a K here for keep. I'm going to keep that 8 over 1. And keep just means it's going to stay the same. We've got 8 over 1. Now I've got to change this division sign into a multiplication operation. And then I'm going to put an F here for flip. So I'll take this 2 over 3 and I'm going to flip it so that it's 3 over 2. Don't worry about the fact that it's improper. That doesn't matter. So now that we have it set up as a multiplication problem, all we have to do is multiply the tops and then multiply the bottoms. So here we've got 8 times 3 equals 24. Again, 8 times 3 equals 24. So that is our top, or our numerator. And here we've got 1 times 2. And that is just 2. And that is our new denominator. This 24 over 2 is improper. What we have to do is we're going to have to turn it into a mixed number by taking the 24 and dividing it by 2. And that's not too bad. Let's set it up over here. So here we'll have 24 divided by 2. 2 goes into 2 one time. That'll be 2. Subtract, I get 0. I'll bring down 4. 2 goes into 4 two times. And that's going to be 4. I'll subtract, and I get 0. So the answer is 12. So 8 divided by 2/3 equals 12. Since there's no remainder, we won't have a fractional part of a mixed number. It's just going to be 12 whole. So therefore, it's, again, 8 divided by 2/3 equals 12. Thanks for watching our video on the math review. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down below. We might use your question in our next video. And if you found this lesson helpful, please make sure you like and subscribe to our channel. And it would really help if you share this and our other videos to any of your social media platforms. See you next time on the Math Review.